Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and as you can see, it's a lovely sunny day, so I thought we'd come out to the garden today to take some portrait photos. Nice as this sunshine is, it does throw up a few problems for us photographers, so in this video, I'm going to show you a couple of ways that we can deal with the shadows. Okay, so let's start with just a basic setup. We're just going to use the camera on program mode and see what happens in this lighting. I've got a model, so my model likes to come in and have a stand by the wall there. Okay, and we're just going to take some pictures. So looking at the pictures, they look fine, but those shadows, they're really, really heavy and not particularly attractive. So what we're going to do is to use our flash gun here and attach it to the top of the camera like that and use this to fill in the shadows. Okay, let's take some pictures. Okay, let's turn that on. That's better. Excellent. Lovely. Now I'm just using the standard program mode here, so we're not doing anything special. Pictures definitely look much better. The flash has really filled in the shadows nicely, but nonetheless the pictures are still pretty flat. So to get a more interesting lighting, we're actually going to get this flash off the camera and work wirelessly. So the idea with off-camera flash is that we can move the flash gun anywhere we want to. That means we control the lighting, and in theory that should give us a better photo. Now, to achieve off-camera flash, I'm working wirelessly with a little remote control, receiver and transmitter. And I'm going to attach these to the camera and the flash gun, and then move my flash gun around and see what different effects we can get. I put the receiver on a small lighting stand, and now I'm going to attach the flash gun to it as well, like that. But to set this up, we need to change a few settings actually on the flash unit itself. So, because this is a reasonably cheap wireless receiver, it can't automatically work out the exposure, so we have to set this manually. So the first thing I'm going to do is to switch to manual mode, and then I'm going to dial down the strength of the flash because it's way too bright. I'm going to put it down to a 1/16th of its usual power. Okay, let's put this over by our little model. So we'll just pop this over here and make sure it's pointing directly at her, like that. That's brilliant. And then we need to set up the camera as well. Now again, we can't work in program mode anymore, we need to set things manually. So I'm going to put the camera onto manual, and I'm going to set a shutter speed, which is exactly the same as the sync speed of my flash, that's 250th of a second. And I'm going to drop the aperture down to f11, like that. Now it's not an exact science, so it gives you a point to start at, but you have to look at the pictures as you're taking them, and then assess the results. So let's take some pictures and have a look. Okay, here we go. Are looking pretty good, and I'm liking the effect of the halo around the subject, but even so we're still getting quite a harsh light. Okay, don't forget the flash isn't a fixed item, you can move it and get different effects. So let's try moving the flash in front of you there. There we go, and we'll try that as well. Okay, so looking at the antenna. Okay, so there we go. We've taken some brilliant pictures, and by moving the light around and getting it off the camera, we've really created something just a little bit more special than the straight picture, even in this really bright condition.